means the vegetation. Natural vegetation means the vegetation which grows naturally on its own without any interference of human being. When the plants are growing on its own means water is given by clouds, seeds are sown by, say, birds, bees, animal movement, water, wind, all agents of gradation. So whenever plants grow on their own, without any kind of assistance given by human being, known as natural vegetation. And we know very well, wherever there is natural vegetation, automatically there would be wild animals. Wild animals means the animals which live in the wild area, in the forested area. We can't separate these two. These two are interdependent. Wherever we'll have wild animals, there would mean jungle are there. And wherever we have jungle, it means wild animals are there. Interdependence is there. And when we talk about India, we say our culture, our country is rich. Rich in what? Rich in this, that in our country we have variety. Variety of animals, why? And variety of forests, why? Our ecology is very rich. We have diversity. Diversity of animals, diversity of greenery, vegetation is also there. Now here question is, why India is rich in this? Why we have enough diversity? Why ecology is so strong in our country? It's because of certain reasons. Now which are those reasons? First of all, we can say relief feature. Everywhere relief feature is not seen. Somewhere we have mountain, forest, plateau, plain, etc. And then we have climatic conditions which are not at all same everywhere. Some areas receive heavy rainfall, some less rainfall, some moderate rainfall. So accordingly, vegetation varies. Then we don't have the same type of soil everywhere. We have various kinds of soil, alluvial, red, black, yellow, mountainous and all that. So because of this, we have variety and variety of flora and fauna in our country. Flora means vegetation and fauna means animal life. So next we are talking about forest. First of all, we are talking about forest. We say we have variety of forest. Like we have, first of all, we can say we have tropical evergreen forest. Then we have tropical deciduous forest. Then we have mountainous vegetation. Then we have desertic vegetation. Then we have tidal vegetation. If we are talking about all these vegetation one by one, we can say we have the areas where heavy rainfall and high temperature, where rainfall as well as temperature both are heavy, we have evergreen forest. And when we talk about evergreen forest, it's clear from the name, those trees which remain green throughout the year. So evergreen forest we have like mahogany, ebony, rosewood, cinchona, etc. So in these forest, trees are very tall, very dense, canopy is there, and dangerous wildlife is there. Even during a daytime, there is no sunlight. So particularly this area commercially is not so much useful. The wood of this area is not so much useful. Why? Because it is not easy to enter in this area. So the areas, if you are talking about this area, western parts of Western Ghats and northeastern seas, this area, we have tropical evergreen forest. Next, we have deciduous forest. Deciduous forest are the forest where rainfall as well as temperature both are high, but not as high as in the case of evergreen forest, or we can say moderate kind. We can say moderate kind. So in such type of forest, we have, or we can divide tropical deciduous forest. Deciduous means what? The trees which shed their leaves at the same time period. Now it means what? Rainfall is not throughout the year. Rainfall is confined to certain time period only. So deciduous forest we can divide into two parts. Dry deciduous forest and wet deciduous forest. Dry deciduous forests are the forests which receive less amount of rainfall, very less amount of rainfall they can survive. And wet deciduous forests which require a bit heavy rainfall. Otherwise rainfall requirement for deciduous forest, that is 120 centimeters. And trees, if you are talking about this deciduous forest, we have kikar, neem, babool, teak, sal, all these forests fall in this category. And if you're talking about area of this deciduous forest, maximum part of India is covered by this. Maximum part of India, excluding Rajasthan, excluding coastal area, that is under deciduous forest. Third, we have mountainous vegetation. Mountainous vegetation has a very important characteristic that vegetation is not same from bottom till top, but it keep on changing. Now here question is, why vegetation is not same? Why it keep on changing? Definitely answer is because of, again, the same point, precipitation. Here I would use the word, because rainfall is mountainous area, there are certain mountainous area where precipitation is in the form of rainfall, and there are certain areas where it is in the form of snowfall. Second is temperature. Temperature automatically it would be less. We know it very well, mountainous region. So temperature can't be higher, temperature is less. And precipitation is in the form of snowfall in certain area. So wherever rainfall is there, yeah, wherever snowfall is here, your temperature is very less, your temperature is moderate to less, we have variety of mountainous vegetation. Like we have tropical deciduous forest, tropical evergreen forest, then we have coniferous forest, then we have alpine vegetation, then we have tundra and taiga kind of vegetation also. And mountainous area, I guess everyone will know about it. All the mountainous area, that is particularly northern part of India and whole of this area, we have mountainous vegetation. Mountainous region, mountainous vegetation. Then we have desertic vegetation. Desertic vegetation, clear from the name, sandy area, desert is here, temperature is high, rainfall is extremely less than 15 centimeter, we can say. And in India, we have prominently two areas we have where we have such kind of vegetation, that is particularly this area, Rajasthan. This area of India, Rajasthan area, and some parts of even MP. Here also we have desertic kind of vegetation. We have cactus, date palm, oasis. Wherever we have oasis, we have cactus and date palm. Okay, coming to Navya. Yes, Navya, ask your doubt, bachche. Navya? Such a... Yes. So we have date palm, oasis, etc. are there in these areas, desertic area. And we know it very well, vegetation is always extremely sparse, less, and definitely the cactus having long roots and thorns are found here. Last, we have tidal vegetation. Tidal vegetation is again clear from the name, tides. We know very well where we commonly tides are found, that is coastal area. So tidal vegetation is a vegetation which is found in the coastal area. In India, we have two prominent coastal area, that is western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. And primarily, tidal vegetation is found in eastern part of India, this area. Tidal vegetation, and tidal vegetation ki quality, if you are talking about, that is mangrove forests are found here. Shallow water is here, saline and fresh water meet with each other and all that. So this is all about your natural vegetation. Next is about animals, wild animals. So wild animals, wherever we have such kind of forest, wild animals will get, though wild animals vary. It can't be same everywhere depending on the climatic condition, the rainfall, the temperature. Certain wild animals like camel, if you were talking about, found in the desert area only. Then we have elephant, Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil, wild ass, Gujarat. Then we have one-horned rhinoceros, Assam. And West Bengal, may we have tiger, gray forest is famous for lion. So we have variety of animals found in different parts of India. And problem is this, ki these not only forests we are cutting down, deforestation is taking, except deforestation, even wildlife is also in danger. So many wild animals, they are under threat, people are killing them. So there's a need to protect forests as well as wild animals. So for this, what government has done? Government has made various policies to protect, various steps have been taken by the government to protect wild animals. For example, projects have been started by the government. These projects you have to learn, and particularly projects are for those animals which are in danger. Like Project Tiger is here, Project One Horned Rhinoceros is here. Except Project Wildlife Protection Act has been implemented by the government, कि इफ एनीवन विल किल एनी स्पेसिफिक स्पीशी व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी इन डेंजर दो देयर इज अ स्ट्रिक्ट पनिशमेंट फॉर द पर्सन एक्सेप्ट दैट बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व नेशनल पार्क वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज बर्ड सेंचुरीज हैव बीन मेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट वेयर एंट्री इज प्रोहिबिटेड मींस इट्स नॉट लाइक दिस कि एनीवन कैन गो देयर इफ यू हैव टू गो देयर डेफिनेटली वी हैव टू टेक परमिशन फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट So this is all about the various steps taken by government, like bird sanctuary, Ranthambore bird sanctuary is here, Kaziranga, Manas, Simplipol, Dutchy Gam, Corbett National Park, Rajaji is here, Kanha is here, Kinhi is here, Sanjay Gandhi National Park is here, south maybe we have Periyar is here. So number of wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries and all that is here which we should know. And the location definitely can be asked. Your exams are approaching. Kya abhi to you are just one day with you, so you have to go through the chapter thoroughly, and you have to go through the maps also thoroughly. Can be asked in your exam. So this is all about the chapter which is natural vegetation and wildlife. Various type of questions can be asked. So chapter we have revised, and now it's your time for to learn the chapter and to attend very good marks. Next chapter which I'm going to revise today, that is after this, that is natural vegetation and wildlife chapter, is climate chapter. For you people, you always say this chapter, consider this chapter as a bit difficult one, but I always say if your concepts are clear, this chapter is extremely easy. Climate is whatever we observe around us, but yes, when we observe around us for 24 hours a day, whatever we have observed, whatever conclusion we have reached, that is known as weather. Weather is day to day atmospheric conditions, means atmospheric condition, yeah, weather conditions means like today is a cloudy day, yeah, today is a sunny day, yeah, rainfall is will take place, yeah, rainfall is taking place, yeah, precipitation is this much, humidity is this much, so all this temperature is this much. So that is about weather phenomena or atmospheric phenomena. So weather means day to day atmospheric conditions, means whenever we talk about the atmospheric conditions of 24 hours or of a single day, we call it as a weather. And climate, there is a difference. Climate is 24 hours conditions. 24 hour conditions means climate is 35 year condition, means when we collect the data continuously for 35 years. What kind of data we are collecting? Again, the data is same, that is weather data, atmospheric data. When we keep on collecting the data for number of years continuously, ultimately we will reach at this conclusion ki in this particular area rainfall is take high, heavy rainfall take place, say in the month of June, July, August. Rainfall is extremely less in the month of say September, October, November, yeah, winter months are November, December, yeah, winter months are say Jan, February, summer months are say May, April, May, June, July and all this. We have reached at this conclusion ki in this area after 35 years, we have reached at this conclusion ki in this area temperature is very high during these months, rainfall is very heavy during these months, yeah, less say whatever it means. We are talking about the climate of any country. And when we talk about the climate of any country, it means we have studied the data, which data? Weather data, for how many years? Near about 30 to 35 years. And after studying any climatic data for such a long time period, we will give a particular name to that country. This country enjoys, say, if you are talking about India, we'll say this country enjoys tropical monsoonal climatic condition. Yeah, if you are living in an equatorial area, say north of Africa, we'll say this country enjoys equatorial type of climatic condition. Yeah, if you are living, say, in Russia, we'll say, yeah, north of Canada, we'll say this country enjoys polar climatic conditions. So depending what type of rainfall is here, what type of temperature is here, which are rainy months, which are dry months, this and that, we will reach at certain conclusion ki this area enjoys tropical climatic condition, equatorial climatic condition, polar climatic condition, etc., etc. So this is the meaning of climate. But one thing we have to keep in our mind, that climate never ever remains same. It keep on changing. It means if we are talking about India, we can't say ki everywhere in India climatic conditions are same. No, not at all. Like right now, winter has started. In south, if you are talking about Kerala, if you are talking about Tamil, there is no sign of winter. If you are talking about Ladakh, if you are talking about Kashmir, Srinagar, extreme winter has already been started there. So it means what? If you are talking about Mumbai, throughout the year, there is no sign of winter. So question is, why so? Why climate keep on varying from place to place? There are certain reasons behind it. The climate everywhere can't be same. There are certain reasons. Let's talk about those reasons. First, we can say, distance from equator. Equator plays a very prominent role when we talk about the climate of any country. Equator means running for the center, central line we are talking about, center of the earth we are talking about. Center of the earth is that place where rays of the sun are always vertical. Always vertical means every time there is a high temperature, every time high temperature indicates we are responsible for rainfall throughout the year. It means every time temperature is high, every day there is a regular rainfall. And in India, if you are talking about, if you remember, south southern part of India, this area of India that is 8 degrees 4 minutes north. 8 degrees 4 minutes north indicate what? 8 degrees 4 minutes north means it is very much close to equator, just a difference of 8 degrees. 8 degrees ka difference is only that. That's why temperature is very high in south, in Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil, because that area is close to equator. But as we are moving from equator towards north of India, towards polar areas, or we can say temperature keep on decreasing. Decreasing in the sense south mein temperature is very high. That's why we don't have a sign of winter season in south, but in north, as we are moving from south to north, temperature decreases. That's why we feel, we experience winter season in north of India. That is distance from equator. Second is distance from sea. Distance from sea never ever remains, temperature never ever remains same if we are moving away from sea. If we are situated in the areas which are coastal areas or very much close to the sea, automatically we'll enjoy equable type of climatic conditions. Equable type of climatic conditions means what? Equal. It's clear from the name. Equable, equal. Throughout the year, January till December, temperature almost remains same. Neither very high nor very low. So why so? It's just because of the influence of winds, that is sea winds and land winds, or we can say sea breeze and land breeze. And this, these breezes we have done number of times. Once again, I'm telling you. So next we have third point, we can say altitude. Altitude is a height above the mean sea level. Height above the mean sea level means what? As we are moving from ground to high hilly areas, temperature will decrease. Now decrease of temperature is fixed, that is 165 meter. After 165 meter, 1 degree temperature drops down. So what does it mean? This is known as lapse rate. So it means what? If you are on a plain area and moving towards the high hilly area, automatically temperature will decrease. That's why, that is the reason mountainous areas always have less temperature as compared to plain area, because density of air, that will definitely would decrease. Plus we are moving away from the land, away from the land, so automatically would lead to the decrease in temperature. So altitude is one of such points. So distance from sea, altitude, except this we have pressure winds. Pressure winds, we have two kind of pressure, high pressure and low pressure. High pressure or low pressure, that is formed due to temperature. We know it very well. Temperature of any place does not remain same. Har jagah same nahi hota hai. Temperature, jaisa temperature hoga, waisa pressure hoga. If temperature is high, pressure would be low. If temperature is low, pressure would be high. So, and due to the formation of pressure, we can say pressure, winds are formed. High pressure is there, low pressure is there, and wind always move from high pressure to low pressure area. So why so? We have again done, low pressure winds will move up, vacuum conditions would be there, and just to avoid this condition, high pressure winds would immediately come and will cover low pressure area. So that is one of, again, one of the reasons. So all these reasons, all of us have done number of times. So just revising the prominent points only. So because of pressure and wind, because of jet stream, jet streams are the very fast blowing winds in the upper layers of atmosphere, and these jet streams are basically responsible for bringing summer or winter season. So jet streams, distance from equator, distance from sea, distance this from the ground to high hill areas or altitude. So these are the prominent points due to which we can say climate never ever remains same, rather it keep on changing from place to place, area to area. So if question is a factors that influence climate of India, you should be able to write down all these points, and with this you will get marks if you will explain it with the help of examples. Next is monsoon. Monsoons are the very winds, seasonal winds, which keep on changing their direction according to season. It means if summer is here, they'll move from sea to land. If winter is here, they'll move from land to sea. So these are the seasonal winds which keep on changing their direction according to season. So monsoons, if in India we are talking about, we have tropical monsoonal climatic conditions. Tropical because we are living in the tropical area, monsoonal because we are under the influence of monsoon winds. So that's why tropical monsoonal climatic conditions we people enjoy. And if you're talking about monsoons, we know very well every year, like right now, you people are ninth and you might have experienced it also, that monsoon winds, they are not permanent. It means that arrival is not permanent. We can't say on this particular date, monsoon will reach in India. It's not like this. If the dates is, say, for example, date they have given, in Kerala, monsoons will reach in the month of, say, 25th of May. So it's not like this one, 25th of May, they'll reach. It can be 30th of May, it can be 1st of June also. So monsoons are unpredictable. Sometimes monsoons give very heavy rainfall. Sometimes monsoons give very less rainfall. Sometimes monsoons give moderate rainfall. So very less or very high automatically cause destruction. Destruction of the economy also side by side. So monsoons, winds, their arrival, their departure cannot be fixed. They are unpredictable. Sometimes they give heavy rainfall. Sometimes they give less rainfall. And next one we can say monsoons are confined to certain time period only. They are not throughout the year. They are confined to say May, June, July, August. So it's not like this throughout the year we are having this monsoons. So confined to certain time period. And next point we can say monsoons don't give equal amount of rainfall everywhere. There are certain areas where heavy rainfall is extremely heavy, like northeastern states. There are certain areas where rainfall is extremely less, like Rajasthan area. There are certain areas where rainfall is moderate, like Punjab area. So it's not like this, they are giving equal distribution of rainfall everywhere through monsoons, not at all like this. So these are the characteristics of monsoon. If you are talking about mechanism of monsoon, it means how monsoons are formed. Monsoons are formed, if you are talking about the prominent point, that is ITCZ, that is intertropical convergence zone is here. And then we have this typical plateau intensely get heated. This point also we have discussed. Then Gibraltar, that is one of the islands which is very much close to Africa. That is also one of the points. So there are number of points which are actually, and pressure winds, undoubtedly pressure winds are actually responsible for these differences in temperature conditions. And due to this, monsoons are formed. So all these are the points related to the mechanism of monsoon. Next is about seasons. We have four kinds of seasons. We have, that is advancing monsoon, retreating monsoon, winter season, and summer season. If you are talking about advancing monsoons, we say we have this season, May, June, July, August, September, when monsoons are approaching. If you are talking about summer season, we know it very well, April, May, June. If you are talking about winter season, that is November, October, December, January, and February. So first of all, if you are talking about advancing monsoons are formed by southwest monsoons, and southwest monsoons are, as it is clear from the name, they come from southwestern direction. They cross equator. After crossing equator, they turn towards right because of Coriolis force. If you remember, we have done it. That is Farrell's law given by Farrell, and which this law says that after crossing equator, winds will move towards the right just because of extreme fast movement of earth near equator. And if winds are coming from north, they will move towards the left after crossing equator. And when these winds change their direction, they are known as southwest monsoons. And southwest monsoons get divided into two parts. And these two parts are Arabian branch and Bay of Bengal branch. And these two branches are actually responsible for giving enough rainfall in India. And if you're talking about Arabian branch, first of all, it will strike to western parts of Western Ghats. After striking to western parts of Western Ghats, it will give very heavy rainfall there. And after giving rainfall in this region, they'll cross that area. They'll reach to the eastern side of Maharashtra. They'll reach to Gujarat. And further ahead, they'll reach to MP, UP, and ultimately they will reach to Punjab. Arabian branch monsoon do not give rainfall in Rajasthan, though it passes through that. Its reason is presence of Aravalli Range. Aravalli Range and the direction of southwest monsoon, Arabian branch, both are parallel to each other. That's what we can say. This branch does not provide rainfall in Rajasthan because of parallel, they are parallel to each other. They don't strike to southwest monsoons, yeah, Arabian branch don't strike to Aravalli, that's why no rainfall take place in Rajasthan. And ultimately, they will reach Punjab, and in Punjab, amount of rainfall is there, though rainfall is not at all so high, it is moderate, less than 75 centimeters. And if you are talking about Bay of Bengal branch, Bay of Bengal branch will move ahead, it will carry moisture from Bay of Bengal, and ultimately, it will move ahead, and Garo Khasi Jaintia range is there, will strike and to Garo Khasi Jaintia, particularly Garo range, and there is one state, that is Meghalaya. Shirapunji city is here, and Mainslam, a village is here, where after striking, these monsoons will give heavy rainfall, a highest rainfall of the world if this area will receive, and then ultimately it will move ahead, but Himalayas won't allow them to move ahead because of their height, and these winds can't cross them because they are very heavy winds, first point, and second is Himalayan ranges are extremely high, so winds cannot cross that area. So ultimately, what will happen? They are supposed to move towards the west. They will move towards the west. They will cross West Bengal, Bihar, UP. Ultimately, they will reach in Punjab and will give rainfall. Though Punjab will receive rainfall, or Delhi will receive rainfall, or northwestern India will receive rainfall from both the branches, Arabian branch as well as Bay of Bengal branch. But the amount of rainfall given by both the branches, that is not at all up to mark. It's not very high, moderate kind of rainfall. We receive moderate, and ultimately these winds will move ahead. J&K is here, but in that area, precipitation would take place in the form of snowfall instead of rainfall. So this is all about your southwest monsoon. Heavy rainfall would be given by them and all that. We have discussed about Kal Baisakhi here. We have also discussed about the meaning, that is mango shower here. Mango shower is Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil, early ripening of mangoes due to pre-monsoon shower. And Kal Baisakhi is experienced in West Bengal, Assam. There's a lot of destruction in Bengal just because of these monsoons, which cause actually destruction. This, after giving rainfall, now the time has come and these winds have to move back. So June, July, August, now September, October. October is the time period when these monsoon winds will go back. And October is also known as October heat in our country, because October month is like this, when ground is extremely wet, cloudless sky is there, there are no clouds in the sky, and evaporation is here, ground is extremely wet. So oppressive conditions, restless conditions we experience in the month of October. So that also experience in October, so that's why we call it as October heat. After this, now scenario has totally changed. India, or we say northern hemisphere, will be far away from the influence of sun. So northern hemisphere will receive winter season, start having winter season. Winter season means high pressure, and southern hemisphere means low pressure. Now winds will start moving from high pressure to low pressure. So winds will start moving from northeastern state and will move towards southern side. When winds will start moving from northeastern state, they are moving coming from land area, so it means they would be deprived of any kind of rainfall, any kind of moisture in it, in these winds. They won't have any kind of motion, rather these winds are dry wind. They will cover each and every part of India, and dryness would be there. Like right now, season has come and we have started feeling dryness. Just because of the dry winds which are moving right now in India, and these winds are known as northeast wind. These winds, from where these winds are coming? These winds are coming from Himalayas, northern part of India, northeastern part of India, and there we don't have any water body. So that's why dryness we right now, we people have started feeling. Plus winter season is there because winds are coming from extreme cold climatic conditions. Area which is totally under snow cover, winds are coming from that area. So cold winds are there. They'll come, they'll cover each and every part of India, and after that, these winds will move ahead, and then some of the winds will pass through Bay of Bengal branch also. And whenever they will pass through Bay of Bengal, whenever they will pass through Bay of Bengal, they'll carry moisture. After carrying moisture, again they'll move ahead, but ultimately what will happen? Eastern Ghats would come on their way, and they are supposed to strike to Eastern Ghats. And whenever they strike to Eastern Ghats, wherever they will strike, that state is known as Tamil Nadu, that area is known as Chennai. And this area, this state will receive, only state which will receive rainfall from winter, during winter season from northeast monsoon. Though these winds are dry, but after carrying moisture from Bay of Bengal, they'll strike, they'll give rainfall. Tamil Nadu or Chennai is the only area which receives rainfall during winter season from northeast wind. Except this area, winter rainfall we also experience in Punjab, obviously northwestern part of India, in the month of January and February. That is from western cyclonic disturbance. Western cyclonic disturbance means disturbance which is coming from Mediterranean Sea. Winds will come from that area, will give rainfall to us, to our states, and ultimately will blow over this Himalayas, and wahan pe a snowfall would take place. Third area which receives rainfall during this in October, November, that is Tamil Nadu area, Andhra area, West Bengal area. Cyclonic rainfall is very common in this region. So these are three areas which receive rainfall from during winter season, and though reasons are different. So any doubt, if you have right now, kindly ask, otherwise I'll proceed.